Today, we're asking 20 random employees here at Sulzer if they can correctly define some of the jargon words we use here every day. First up is shake and bake.
Talladega Nights.
That's from Talladega Nights. Yeah. Shake and bake.
Ricky Bobby.
Yeah.
Shake and bake.
There we go.
Shake and bake.
That's right.
No idea.
That sounds familiar.
Shake and bake.
Yeah, that's that stuff you put in the bag and shake with
chicken.
The chicken.
Pork chops.
Ooh, dinner. Mom used to make that years ago.
No, actually, that's a term for just a cleanup, reconditioning.
That's new to me. That is new to me.
It's not the Ricky Bobby thing, but that's where you clean and recondition a motor, put it in through the bake oven process and clean it.
Next up, jumper.
Oh, a lot of different jumpers.
It's what you use to start your car.
Jumper cables.
Are those one-piece bodysuits? They're jumpers.
Wow, yeah. No idea whatsoever.
Well, a jumper is just a fancy term for a sweater, especially if you're English in the UK. Is that what it is?
Not really. It's a term for stator connections.
So it's basically you're connecting one wire to another wire using a jumper.
A zero for two.
That's okay. What about pickle?
That's usually what we're in when we're running late on a job.
Pickle.
That's a game. That's where you keep something away from somebody in the middle.
Pickle. Remind me of my dinner tonight.
Oh, I love to eat pickles.
We have them in the fridge.
Yeah, good on hamburgers.
I like pickles so much that I bring a pickle with me for our meeting today.
Isn't it like the motors? They look like a pickle.
It's an old term for a generator rotor.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I knew that.
Yeah, it's called a pickle. That is a pickle.
Learned something new today.
It was the pickle of the day, for sure.
I heard that about a year ago. I thought the guy was crazy.
I've never heard anybody here call that a pickle.
What is push and pull?
Sounds like what the instructor was yelling at me in workout class the other day.
You always give me the heavy side of the stuff when I go upstairs anyways, so I'm always pushing and you're always pulling.
No idea.
Maybe when they're moving the rotor.
I'm guessing it's what you'd call the float term for a sleeve bearing rotor.
Checking the in play, maybe?
That's a trick question to make us look bad.
Pulling a motor out and reinstalling the motor?
That's removal and installation of a motor or pump on site.
Look at you go. High five.
Working my way up to an A.
Nice. How about a bad actor?
Who's that girl from the Twilight movies?
Oh, Kristen Stewart. Oh, Tom Cruise. Good one. Yeah.
Tom Hanks.
I would disagree.
Adam Sandler. A motor acting up.
Oh, a bad actor. Well, that's a machine that's extremely unreliable.
You got that right.
Now for an easy one. Tell us what an end bell is.
End bell.
You know what that is?
Yeah.
Do you really?
Yeah. End bell on a motor.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's easy.
All right.
That's not even tough.
Great.
End bell.
Any more to that?
Oh, what is the description? Oh,
that's the last call for school to be out.
That's what I was thinking, school. You couldn't wait for that end bell.
Yeah.
Any finance questions you want to throw our way, and feel free.
Oh, it's the end of the motor.
The end brackets of a motor.
It's like a cap.
And the last one, pigtail.
Pigtail. You pull it and they go oink.
That is it's a Mexican delicacy, isn't it?
He used to have one until we shaved it off.
I should know that one, actually.
I've heard that before.
A hairstyle adult women shouldn't wear?
Maybe, but not what we're looking for here.
Pigtail.
Yeah, I believe it's a lead extension.
That's something like they'll hook up on leads and run out and plug in.
High five.
All right.
I think we rocked.